Hello everybody, this is Flamo5 here, and today we are playing Minecraft. Okay. Is the music still going? Seriously? How's that happening? Okay. Alright, whatever. So, I haven't made an episode in a little bit here. I've been on a little bit of a break, and I think part of that has been because I haven't been super motivated for the last little bit here, and that has been because I've watched your video and I was thinking, it's kind of laggy. It's not as laggy when I'm recording, it just shows up laggier for some reason, and I don't know why. I think it has to do with something with my settings. I changed my settings a little bit, so hopefully it should be a tiny bit higher quality. You might not notice, I don't know. Might not even be something that you can even tell. I changed it from like 70% to 80% or something out of 100, so I don't know. So whatever. I get the same frame rate as like Ethos Lab when he's recording, so I don't quite understand why that happens, but whatever. So what we're gonna be doing today is we're gonna be making a bigger farm. I thought about it a little bit for a couple seconds before, just a couple seconds, but I thought about it a little bit before I was going to start the episode, and I thought, you know, might be a pretty good idea because this farm is designed for me just to get a tiny bit of wheat on the first night, pretty much, of the game, and I feel like that's all it's really benefited me, if you know what I mean. So I'm thinking, I don't know exactly where to put it, but I'm assuming I'm probably going to put it like right in this little V here. Because I have a tendency to run across here, but that's what the paths are for, so I go this way. So it's more, you know, classy, if you know what I mean. So, yeah, we're going to do that so that I don't do that. It's kind of a strange limitation when I really think about it, but I think it'll be fine overall. Let me just get some of these fences. I'll just shift-click. Some spare, I'll just keep that. 28, that's not very much. That is not very much indeed. But I guess I'll just have to see. This might be enough, I don't know exactly. Probably not. We're gonna probably take it up to about there is fine. It's not a huge farm. It's not a huge farm, you know, but it's a big enough farm where I can obtain, you know, enough wheat and stuff to keep me alive, I guess. And I'm sure I have some more dirt. I'm sure I have more dirt somewhere. Yes. I have a lot of dirt, so I was just thinking, you know. I want to expand this all the way out to the coastline so that it's sort of like, so that mobs can't really get on. Oh, but I have my reeds. How am I going to do that? I'll probably just go like up here. That's probably fine. Normally I run through the reeds like this and just chop them as I'm running. So that should be fine. I'm just gonna do this. Maybe put a little like ladder there or something, or maybe some stairs. And there's a creeper down there. I want to cover up this hole a little bit. I think I completely mined it out, so I'll probably never really go down here again, actually. And if I do, it'll be because I fall down here, so I think it's a good idea to just cover this up. Now, some of you guys might know about the Yogscast and their series called MoonQuest. Now, I kind of been watching that a little bit. The Yogscast is like the biggest, you know, like PC gaming channel like that's around, I guess. Except for PewDiePie, actually, now that I think about it, because I thought he does console. I never really watched him. frankly, because I don't think that I related to his content that much, but he is very popular. Very popular. Oh, I have my sword. For a second I thought I didn't have my sword and I was getting all worried. Let's just sharpen this one. Not the best sword ever, but I think we can handle it. There's second power. Okay, so I'm just gonna finish filling this in. You might notice that I have a slightly, you know, deeper voice, and that is because I just have a stuffy nose. Recently, where am I getting? I'm just trying to make everything a lot more complicated than it really needs to be. My dad does that all the time. It's really funny, but it's funny because like you know, you can tell he's really trying hard to try to talk in a way that would be very hard to understand. But you can understand him pretty well. It's just like he tries to use big words. I can't think of big words that he uses right now, but I might think of one in a second. Anyway, so we need to finish that farm. I'll probably like plant all the crops offline, but I'll just give you a basic idea of how big it's going to be, and then I'll probably pause the video, build it, and then I'll be right back. I don't know how far. How about here? Let's see how many blocks it is. Let's just go one more, actually. There we go. So, time to build it. What just happened? Alright, guys, so one thing I want to put right here is a pond. Because I'm not a huge fan of this. I have to do it on this side. I just can't get around it on this side. But on this side, there's not really a lot of space for me to do that without sort of like losing some of my precious sort of stuff, crop, whatever. Actually, I wonder, how far does... I'm actually going to look that up right now. Okay, I looked it up, and it said that a common way of planting crops is to make a 9x9 square and put... And where the middle... the perfect middle block, you know, is water. So, I thought about that for a few seconds, and then I just tested it to be absolutely sure. And water can spread 4 blocks. So yeah, I don't need this right here, because it'll go 4 blocks. And on this side, it's a different story. I wonder if... See, here's the thing. Sometimes I sort of zone out for a second, and then I come back, and then I think... I wonder how long I was just speechless there, and then I assume that it was probably like a minute that I was just sitting there doing nothing. But, really, it was just, probably like a couple seconds, and then I apologize, and it's like, what? You just stopped talking for a couple seconds. Because it feels like I just zoned out for a minute, because I get all scared and stuff, so. I don't know how long I was not talking there for a second, and you probably didn't even notice it. But anyway, oh yeah, I went to a swamp. How did I not remember? Anyway, so I went to a swamp, I got like 45 blue orchids, so pretty good. Well, I think I planted a couple of them. I want to plant these around. Those blue orchids, like, kind of my favorite. These are also my favorite. These two are my favorite. I don't like most of the other flowers. I pretty much only like these two. For some reason, I don't know. Just the way I am. And yeah. There we go. I like these two. Best. I'm planting the other ones just for the sake of diversity. I actually do like... I don't like a lot of them, but I do like some of them, if you know what I mean. I like the I like these in this fashion. I really like this building. I think I did a not half bad job for the fact that I only used wood and cobblestone to build it. I don't think it looks half bad for just wood and cobblestone, but you know, it's a subject of opinion. Or I guess. Is that right? I got a couple more bookshelves as well. I made an anvil. That's just a little update on what I did offline. I went mining as well. You probably saw the chest. I got what is it? 7 diamonds. So you know, wasn't terrible mining expedition. Depending on who you are, it wasn't that long. I don't mine for a very long time. I normally just watch one video while I'm mining, so it's on my other monitor. So it's normally not like a super long. What am I even talking about? I don't even know what I'm talking about. It's normally not like a super, you know, whatever. Let me just see here. How do I want to make this pond? Okay, let me see. I keep trying to tell this, it's driving me crazy. I just need to design the pond. One thing I need is a lily pad, so I'm gonna go off, find a swamp, grab some lily pads, because you just sort of need those as a necessity. You know what I think they should add? You might think this is crazy, but poppy seed muffins. Are you with me? Poppy seed muffins? Because I feel like they need more like pastry type things in this game. So I think poppy seed muffins would be good because it adds another use to the new flower update. You know, poppy seed muffins. Huh? If you like the idea, then go tell Jeb, tweet Jeb, add poppy seed muffins. I'm not, I don't make the game. You know, I'm not even close to making the game in terms of my intelligence with Java programming, but you know, if I was to say how I think it should be crafted, in my opinion, I would say you'd use a poppy flower, and then you would use some like a piece of wheat and a poppy and a flower, flour, a piece of wheat, and then a piece of paper, I guess, if you wanted, and then you could get poppy seed muffin in the paper. That's just my opinion. That's just my of how I think it should be crafted. But any idea would work. I'm not. You know, he's never gonna add it, but like, I'm just saying, you know, it'd be an awesome idea, in my opinion. I'd love that, but it's probably not gonna happen. I could mod it in, but it's probably not gonna happen. I should actually mod it in. It's a good idea. Another thing they need. It's just, if I was making the game, there's just so many little things that I'd add. Like, hard-boiled eggs. It's a big one. Versus boiled eggs and hard-boiled eggs. Anyway, I'm getting distracted. When I come back, I'll probably have some lily pads. Wait, let me just put this away real quick. I want to make it really flowery, if you know what I mean, around the pond. Well, not really. I don't want to make it too flowery. I want it to be very, not flowery, but you know what I mean, sort of, you know. It's the perfect opportunity. Crap, no, it's not the perfect opportunity anymore. Okay, come on, the creeper over here. Kill. Crap, crap, crap. Okay. Let's go over here. Come on, skeleton. You're so stupid. Anyway, I'm gonna keep going and looking for that swampity doodah thing, you know, ding dong thing, whatever. It's funny how it's all like stone. There's like no signs of life. Except for this thing. Right. It's Funny how I caught so much salmon. I don't know if I recorded. I think I uploaded that time I was fishing, like, and I was expecting that I'd get like 30 levels from fishing, not realizing how few levels you really do get, and how it take forever and stuff to try to get 30 levels. So yeah, I really need 30 levels, but by the time I get like 20 levels, I always die, so it's kind of annoying. There we go. Yeah, I think if I keep going, we'll find a swamp this way. Oh, mushroom. Oh, roof forest. Yes, roofed forest. Yes, I know where I am. I know where I am. I know where I am. I'm the roof forest biome. I think there's a, I've gone mining here before. I need to get some roof forest sapling. Some, not roof forest. Dark oak saplings. They're like my, like, one of my favorite types of trees. Dark oak is. I don't actually like a lot of the wood, you know, the different wood colors. Like, an example of one of those is, I really don't like birch and jungle. Those are two of my very least favorite ones. You might have a different opinion, but those are two of my least favorite ones. It's an interesting thing to talk about, like, what your favorite type of wood is in terms of looks. A lot of the people who have been playing Minecraft for a long time would say oak. And I would say oak, too. And it... I don't know why, it's just that I've been around for a long time, and to me, woods having different colors is sort of a new thing, and I kind of despise it a little bit, because it was one of the, I hated the update when it came out, because I realized, you know, now I can't just build using any tree, I have to use the same tree each time, or else it's going to look weird, you know, but, you know, I guess there's advantages and disadvantages to everything, but, you know, it's just kind of annoying. And, you know, certain mods have tried to remedy it, but I don't think it's any of them really done very well. It's the idea of having the different colored woods, I think, is nice, but it's sort of a problem in that, you know, the whole, the Uniwood thing is, Uniwood. That sounds weird. Uniwood. The one type of plank thing, I think, you know, the interior works better, but did I get any saplings? I always go and just chop down trees and totally leave the saplings and never come back for them, but I really need to start coming back for the saplings when I'm trying to get a new tree, you know. Okay. Any saplings? I need 4, so... Got 1... 2, there we go, 3 and 4, there we go, we're good to start our tree farm. And I'm going to use this type of wood, because, in my opinion, it's the best for, you know, making different things out of wood. I'm not just saying that because Etho says that, well, maybe I am, but, you know, it has lots of advantages. And if you want to know those advantages, you should watch Etho's Minecraft video about it, where he's making his tree farm. Yeah, watch that one, and then you'll understand. Etho is my favorite, like, sort of YouTube, you know, guy. There we go, that's the swamp I was looking for. I've been here before. Yes. For a second, I thought I wasn't gonna make it. Am I crazy? Or, you know... Because I think the swamps are slightly different in terms of color now. And I did not, just telling you, I did not grab all of these. There were tons more of these that I just didn't get. One thing that I've sort of, this is sort of random, but one thing that I've sort of felt like since starting this game is that I'm just really bad at, with in terms of, you know, just keeping my bearings is one thing that I have the hardest time trying to do that. I always get lost is my thing. And most people are better at remembering where stuff is than me. And I think part of it is I just sort of don't pay attention, but You know, like when I'm going mining, I just sort of wander until I find a cave. I always have that problem that I never can find a cave either. And so I always end up just mining down at sort of a angle. Because when you do that, you're more likely to hit a cave as well. Very high chance once you get to that point. I want to get a lot of these. I'm probably going to pause the video now. And then I'll be back once we get to the house. Just wanna have a good amount. I think 20. Now I'll get 32. I'll be right back. Okay, I'm back, and I just made a I made a ton of torches. You probably saw it in my inventory. I had even more than that, actually. I had a couple stacks. And I just made a torch path all the way to there where I was. I went through that way, actually, is the way I went. And then I went sort of like that. I went like over there and then over there eventually. But this is the faster way. I was using cords because I knew that I think my house is something like 200 on one of the axes, and then something else on one of the axes. I just knew generally they're both. If you put me at the coordinate 0, 0, then I would know how to get back. What did I get out of that? Just a bottle or something. Just a bottle. 0, 0 is over there. Is in that forest. So my house is in a biome that borders the biome that's at the coordinate 0, 0. Technically. Well, if you include rivers, it borders a biome that borders a biome. So yeah. Pretty interesting stuff. Okay guys, so we can finally make our little thingy whatever here. I think through that expedition I've eaten like a lot of my food because I had to eat a lot of food during that little period of time. So have a ton of food. It's kind of interesting because I used to be, for me anyway, when it comes to like mod packs, I really love technical mod packs. This game, they're the best. But the problem is, I always get so addicted to them that normal Minecraft seems pointless, and so that I never play normal Minecraft. But eventually, like an update for Minecraft will come out or something like that, and then I, you know, stop playing the mod pack and start playing there, or you know, it starts getting boring, I play another game and then I eventually come back to just normal Minecraft. That's sort of what ends up happening. Or I just eventually decide to just start playing normal Minecraft again. Lots of different. Lately, in the past, I played lots of Tekkit. Tekkit, I checked out. It's pretty cool now. I still play a lot of normal Minecraft. I'm trying to get to the point where I can be like a normal person and sort of do a little bit of both. I say normal person, assuming that most people do that. It might just be that all the people that make, you know, in fact, well, I'm not sure if it's normal person actually, because like a lot of people do only make, you know, Minecraft videos with mods or stuff like that, you know, so, you know, like an example of a person that does that is Direwolf20. He has never done anything in normal Minecraft, like, it's crazy. I don't think he's ever played normal Minecraft before. I still watch his videos because, I used to not watch his Forgecraft videos, and I used to only watch his server play, but, now that is Forgecraft has thermal expansion, I got hooked back into it. I used to think that it wasn't really a technical mod pack, it was just sort of like a random mod pack, you know, one of those random mod packs, or sort of random bigger mods. Another thing I found out, I recently watched a video, and it was an Ant Venom video, and he said he's gonna be playing a mod pack. I'm not a huge fan of Ant Venom. It's not that I don't like him. I'm not saying I'm not a huge fan and that I don't like him. I just, you know, I watch his videos on the occasion. a lot of what he does is stuff that I don't really watch, and that's why I'm saying, I'm not saying I don't like his videos, it's just a lot of it's stuff that I'm not really interested in. And by that, I mean, what was I saying? Minigames. Trying to get the perfect combination here so that I can use the least amount of buckets. And I don't know exactly how I'm gonna do that. This guy here. There we go. God, those sheep were really annoying. Another thing I'm gonna do is I'm just gonna plant these. Now, we are actually coming to the end of the video pretty soon here. It's been like 26 minutes, 27 minutes, something like that. You're looking at the time right now and correcting me and saying it's 23 minutes or something. It's above 25 minutes, I know that. So it's wrapping up time's coming pretty soon here. I just wanna make this pond. And it should be able to reach. 1, 2, 3. Yeah, I can reach. Let's see. The point of this pond is for aesthetics and just to fertilize this because it, you know, can't be fertilized otherwise. So yeah. Where should I put these? Probably like over here, right? So. Okay, let's actually go like this, and then I'll delete the ones I don't want. That seems easier. I don't want that one, 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 or this one, or that one, or that one. There we go. There we go. Like that. So I got these guys, and I'll sprinkle some more over here a little bit. Got some lily pads, and now I'm just going to add in some sugar cane. And then, so, I wish I had something I could do to wrap up the video, So video's coming to a close. I'm probably gonna put in I'm probably gonna put in like a little bench over here as well, actually, so out of stairs in the next episode. So bye, and I'll see you in episode number, I don't even know what episode this is. Probably like 5, 6, 7. One of those three. And yeah, so bye guys.